KSP live stream. I'm Lorenzo. I haven't done streaming in more than a year and a half. Holy shit, time goes so fast. But we have recently concluded the XCOM 2 series. Oh, actually, those videos are still rendering. There's no way you would have seen that. Anyway, we're starting a XCOM 2 Legends or again Commander difficulty stream in the future. But first, I wanted to have a quick look at the previous favorite game, Kerbal Space Program. They have just released a 1.1 version, and actually, I should say it's a pre-release version, and that should there's still leeway for bugs and stuff. But we're gonna have a look at it regardless. Release stream. We'll make a sandbox save game to see if there's any massive changes in the game. I haven't played it in months, to be honest. It's just I have about 600 hours into it, and well, it does get a little bit stale after a while. Let's see. We have the space center. This looks familiar. The big change here is that the change to Unity 5 or whatever. No, the Unity 64-bit that is important. I am being distracted because my Twitch icon is still reading as offline. I'm going to refresh my laptop, see if that will go to online. It does say configuration, it does say quality excellent, so I will ignore it apparently being offline. That, well, if nobody ever sees this, we'll deal with that later. Anyway, we have the Space Center. I see icons, they are new. Oh, no more hunting for the buildings. That's very welcome. It's very, very welcome. Cool, I got it. Go to the astronaut complex as per usual. Flagpole. Oh, we can change the flags here. Great, let's pick one. I've never done this. Goliath Nation, I think. Launch pad. We can launch something. Cool. Runway. Yeah, this is all familiar. The resolution doesn't seem... Ooh, this is not familiar. What is this? The manual! Oh my god! This is something else again. A whole manual. Wow. I got into this game at like version 0.10, and a manual like this is actually pretty darn polished. This is great. Heat. Heat is new. Whoa, as you are now an expert as orbital mechanics, we will dive right in. Part to part, part to environment, heat injection. Yes, we will. Body radiation not shown to save space. Oh, that also does it. Cool. Yeah, we will. What is this? Feeling the flow in city research modules. The flow of heat is not instantaneous. Resources. Or this is... I know many of these things, but so many things are now incorporated in the standard game. That's pretty amazing. Hey, we've got the first Cheddar. Hi, Griswolf. I am indeed online. We're trying a stream of Kerbal Space Program 1.1. I'm just mesmerized by the manual at this point. And there should be a few second delay again, which makes chat to streamer communications very difficult. By the way, how did you find the stream? It's probably not you checking me every minute. That would be creepy. Anyway, let's go and try and shoot a rocket into space or something. That's what you're supposed to do in this game, if I remember correctly. We'll grab a command pod, one of them biggins. Parachute on it, and well, we want to give it enough fuel to reach into space, because we want to check out the re-entry mechanics, so we need to give it lots and lots. Let's see, where is my rocket fuel? No, I want, yeah, here's my trusty orange tank. I know nothing about this game anymore. There's so many parts, I haven't played in months, and to be honest, it's a nice surprise to have the new update to play around with. I will not put afterburner turbofan, that sounds violent. Let's go with what we know. a mainsail, and we're not building here to be efficient. We're building here to play around with the new systems. So let's get a simple size adapter. Some bigger tanks. Where are they? Here. Should be a bigger one around as well, but this will have to do. I reckon this will get us nicely off the bat. Is it giving me design checklist? Unused monopropellant? We don't care about that. Yes, this is good enough. Oh, cool, yeah. Rule is saying in chat that he found me using the Twitch now and I'm on his subscriber list. So yay, I'm somewhat findable by the people that watched these streams years and years ago. We'll see how to work at that popularity in the future. So far it hasn't skyrocketed, not yet. Hey, the static on the Jebediahs has the color pips in them now. Anyway, let's light this sucker up. Here we go. This all looks very familiar. I can steer the rocket, which I probably shouldn't do too much to prevent catastrophic rapid disassembly. And yeah, the planet looks the same. I know those mountain ranges fairly well. I've crashed many a rocket into them. We're trying to angle over the ocean as pro rocket scientists are wont to do. We'll eject. We'll eject Bob Kerman, why not? He wasn't. Yay, that's one Kerbal down. I don't know why I did that. Probably to save some mass. Bob was snacking on the hamburgers way too much. Alright, this is where we have potentially some aerodynamic effects. We are going really fast in the lower atmosphere. This could start to turn into heat gases. Heat gases? No way. Compression shockwaves. Hey, I think I'm seeing red glows over the planet, some lighting shaders that weren't in there before. Anyway, we should probably try and make something ridiculously large to test these performance upgrades that were rumored to be in the new Unity engine. Let's see, we are reaching at 30 kilometers here, and we're going almost straight up, despite my feeble attempt at angling over. Oh, whoa, I get a right click, and then there is a line. Oh, such a simple line will make all the difference. Here we go. These menus have been sanitized. Show actuation toggles. No, we're not going to do that. We're also not going to activate the thing. Cool. Crew report. Yeah, why the hell not? Oh, this is sandbox. Safe to deploy. Risky. Yeah, I can imagine. Alright, the fuel is all empty. I'm wondering where, if I can find some temperature gauges. Oh, here I can like lock the roll axis. Cool, that's all more polished than it was in the past. Ditch this stage. And of course I didn't bring any attitude control. The atmosphere is a lot nicer. In chat they're saying that the atmosphere got improved. I saw scatter effects on our ascent. That is definitely a lot nicer. Let's see this planet from a distance, try and catch some sunsets to properly observe those effects. Let's see, this still resembles... Oh look, there is now a difference in what has happened and what is projected to happen. Or this is coincidence. Is there a oh, there is a difference maybe in rising and falling? This is this bit we're ascending and here we're descending, or it's just a shader applying to the orbit. Anyway, let's time warp to ApoApps. Can we do that here? Warp here, yes. Alright, that's a nice feature. I think that's not new in this version per se. Alright, time warp has completed. That means we are going to angle our ship prograde. Give it a little bit of engine thrust to, you know, get steering input. Full boost. And here we have an orbit that's going to skim the atmosphere nice and low. So we, well, as I said, hopefully we're going to catch a nice sunrise, which can show us the atmosphere of things. Get it? The atmosphere. the atmosphere, the vibe. Oh, never mind. Alright, here we go. That was a little bit too fast. From here, I'm not seeing any marked differences. Although there is a little bit of fuzziness around the edges that could... I have trouble deciding whether that's new or old. Anyway, let's get back down to the planet and... Actually, let's make it a really fast re-entry. Let's try and burn up this stock capsule with no heat shield. We're going to burn prograde. We're going to rise to increase the altitude of our orbit as much as we can. And then fire dive into Kerbin. Well, I can rise it up more than this, but that will only add like 30 meters per second, so there's not a whole lot of point into doing that. We're going to try and incinerate this capsule. Let's see if that works. Destruction testing is the best testing. We're going to aim retrograde, a little bit of engine thrust, and we're going to aim for a nicely incinerating altitude of like 0 kilometers. That should give us some scorch marks. Let's time warp forwards into the planet. There's the planet. Here we go. The sun is hiding behind it. Oh, that is a nice... This definitely was a nicer effect with it eclipsed, and we could see the atmosphere around it. That was good. And it's those little things on here as well. The sun lit part. That's definitely some better shaders. All right. I wanted to burn up the rocket on our way down, but we couldn't do that because I forgot, and then we're gonna do that now. We probably need to turn around now. Ooh, there's the new heat bars. Let's ditch this capsule. Ooh, that's going wrong really fast. But can I also see... Oh, and distant parts also get heat toggles. I mean, let's not forget, we're going... There's a light going on here. Is that a G-force light or a... Actually, the G-forces aren't that strong yet, but we're going at... 3.5 kilometers per second still, and we're going to start slamming into the thicker part of the atmosphere. We are screwed. We should be screwed. This is a way too fast re-entry. This bar is red at least, and we explode. Nice. Today, that's a massive success. Alright, let's go to the Space Center. What else can we play around with? Do we want to the tracking station? Are there any bodies that we could want to go to? Could visit Elo and Jewel. I've done those. What's one that they haven't really been? We can try and go for Eve. Eve is always fun with its thick atmosphere. Let's make a rocket that goes to Eve. We will get one. We'll make a lander, and it's not going to get up again, because if you go to Eve, you're not coming back. That's always the rule. It's going to be a one-person lander. One parachute should do it. Obviously, we are going to want to slow down before slamming into the atmosphere at full speed. We learned that that's not that great of an idea. Do we have heat shield parts? That's a... necessity for an Eve mission, I think. I'm not seeing any heat shield parts here, but there are a frightening amount of parts. Let's see. Not in structural, maybe advanced mode where we can get filter by function. Oh, yeah, that's this. That's not great. I want to filter it by... Is ablator is a resource. Yeah, here we go. Integrated fairing, a small heat shield, great. With this, from this capsule, our pilot will be able to step out and set foot on the ground. So what do we need then? We need some kind of horrendously efficient aeroshell to break this. And I kind of want it in the form of a plane, because if we make a plane, we can have some control over where we land. This is going to be our last ditch effort. That means the heat shield actually has to go, because if we're gonna enter nose first, we're gonna need our heat shield on the nose. Let's see, stack decoupler, because after we crash our plane into the air, we will need to land on just the capsule. Let's see, where is my rocket fuel? Filter by resource. Liquid fuel. Oh yeah, this is of course going to be a rocket plane, because the air on Eve is not oxygenated. We cannot really have a traditional plane there. But we might be able to have a traditional rocket plane there. These big wings, we are going to be going to Eve, which has really thick air, so we're going to need only very small wings. This is me being a pro rocket scientist, don't you forget it. We are of course also going to need a lot of reaction control systems, because no way that our undesigned plane is going to do it. We need some control surfaces. Aeroplane control surface. Yeah, we'll have the large version of that, just so we'll not have the large version of that, we'll have the small version of that. Let's see what we have. The Elevon 5, why not? Yes, this looks like it should work. Maybe. Let's actually try it out. We will dub this the Eve for its target destination. Save and launch. Let's see if this works. It doesn't work here because our engine is too feeble. Okay, that's a lesson. Revert flight to the assembly building. The gravity on Eve is of course much stronger than it is here on Kerbin. Now we don't want to lift off from there again, but we do want to have some kind of a control authority. This is so not going to work, this plane, but hey, you can dream. You never know. You never know. So, let's see. Can we actually... No, we need a tail fin as well. The problem with putting a tail fin on a rocket... Actually, no, this works, sort of. I spin when I try to yaw, but... Maybe my controls are just wrong. Yeah, this works here, we can control everything. I just need to set up my control keys properly. And maybe add a tail fin. But that, as I was saying, adding a tail fin on a rocket can cause problems. Let's see, can we also glide? We probably cannot glide. Actually. Oh yeah, right is up, left is down, down is left, up is right. That's why things went sort of wrong first. Yeah, we can glide. This would work a lot better on Eve, I'm sure. This is like an airfish. No sophistication at all. And we're going to need, because this is going to come into Eve, we're going to need electric charge, first and foremost. Lots and lots of it. We're going to want to bring a little generator. Let's see. Yeah, this works fine. This is actually a great glider. Full thrust. Let's try and alter our course upwards. Yeah, this is gonna be so fine. The only thing we have to worry about is slowing down once we get to Eve. Everything will be fine with this gigantically fantastic plane. Alright, cannot have an easier to fly craft. All the flight testing came back with was a massive success. We are going to need, as I said, lots and lots of batteries. We will slap them on the side, because that's the best place to keep your batteries, on the side. and we will have a few solar panels that will probably shear off once we reach the atmosphere, but these are strictly for in-space usage only. Alright, we have our emergency eject system here. We have a plane for steering through the atmosphere. Now all we need is a rocket system to get there. Should be easy enough. Let's see, this thing is fairly light. We should be able to get away with a non-too special booster system. Let's make it one size bigger. Oh, not that big. One size bigger. That's too small. Where's the intermediate adapter? Use this one. No. This one. The medium-sized adapter. We will have a transit stage consisting of... not this tank. One and a half tank I want. This one I want. We'll have a transit stage that's basically this. Engines. We'll have the efficient Poodle engine. And then we'll have a Rocomax branded decoupler with the largification system. With some fuel tanks. This one is the one I meant earlier. Let's have a proper separating ascent stage. Not these tiny boosters. We want massive boosters. Let's see. We have stack separators here. I learned a few months ago that you should put them at the top with toggle snap. Toggle snap sounds like it could be the new app genius super success of 2017. Things are getting dumber and dumber if you ask me. So, toggle snap, super app. It even rhymes. And meanwhile, I am just looking for this little baby. I'm gonna put two of these and then get these booster engines. Where are they? These ones, the twin bores. So that's technically duo quad bores. I think that should be able to lift our little Eve soldier all the way to the stars. Now, I could make these asparagus staged, but to be honest, that just sounds like too much effort. Airstream, but this is not what I want. I want an aerodynamic cone, this one here. There we go, and we're probably going to need some struts to keep it all together. From here to here. And a few from the plane wings to the rocket engine. And I probably want to disable those wing control surfaces. That didn't do anything. I probably want to disable those wing control surfaces for the launch. I'm building a hole. Oh! This is my trick. If something happens in the editor that you're not happy with, just make it happen. And then hit Control Z, universal undo key. Alright, seems like a proper booster. Whoa, and the chat is saying I should look at the surge function. Whoa man, heat shield. Oh my god, the surge function is the best thing in the world. My god. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the fix for so much little frustration. It's the best. Alright, do I want to get a massive heat shield on the front here? Maybe I do, actually. Maybe I do. Maybe I want a tiny decoupler. Can I search for decoupler? Oh yes, and get the smallest decoupler I want. Then back to heat shields. Oh, it's not even gonna let me misspell. Oh, it still finds it if I do it horribly. Oh my god. This is good. This is certainly good. Maybe my wings will be toasty this way. But they will be toasty anyway. Now, of course, I need a parachute. Oh my god. This is just the best. I had no idea. If you were to ask me what's your most requested feature, it would not be a search function. But it should have been. Oh my god. this is literally really, really good. Can we do with a... I'm gonna have one solar panel. Just the one. Can I have my solar panel, please? Yeah, just the one solar panel. And then have two parachutes. That will impart the least imbalance into the craft. Alright, we're gonna launch it like this. It says I can even type descriptive things. Slowing down. Braking. Not too descriptive. Aero brake gives me a lot. Help, help, the ground is coming. No, that shouldn't be. Anyway, the search for instant is glorious. And now we can resume. Launch clamps. We can resume adding launch clamps. Because that's a thing we were doing. Here we go, and now we're going to set up the staging. Oh, even the staging setup is much more spiffy than it was. Everything is greater, better, more awesome. I am loving this to bits. This should fire at once. This should fire at once. Yes, and then what's this one? This one, and... ooh, that one certainly shouldn't fire there. These two should fire at once, and then... this one is correctly the last. Yeah, this all makes sense. Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Surface preview. I wonder how terrible this thing will perform. Let's lock these things. Authority limiter. Deploy direction. Inverted. Normal. Whoa, I can make them do things. Retracted. Alright, we will not have them be steering. They are linked together, that is good. Alright then, here we go. Lift off. So far so good. The boosters are doing their jobs. Valentina is on their way to Eve. We have engine 1, 2, 3, 4, and the 1, 2, and 3 are orange. Is that heat related? Sideways because we are carrying aerodynamic surfaces after all. So we're going to brake back one soon. Actually already did. We're going to throttle back slightly because our engines are a little bit overpowered at this point now that we've burned some fuel. Now we need to get into orbit and then establish a transfer to Eve, which shouldn't be too difficult, but it has been a while. I'm a little bit out of practice, but we'll see how that goes. Let's try and turn over first. It doesn't make sense to be too scared about this. That said, I'm already unable to stop my turn. Full power is never the solution. Alright, let's see if we can ride this out. Full power, we'll try and go straight up again. Yes. A little delay, but we're on our way to Eve again. We'll try that turn again when there's a little bit less atmosphere, like now. With a little bit less power, so we're not completely blasting everything out of the way. Let's see if the stream is still working, actually, because my copy has crashed. Let's hope that didn't happen for the rest of the world. I'm not quite sure. Of effort to run a stream. Oh my god. Well, at least the video is still working. That was just my laptop not being adequate for the 1080p stream, I suppose. Alright, we are almost out of the atmosphere. Now comes time to ditch the boosters. This is very scary, but we're not in the atmosphere, so we don't have to make it scary. We'll just give a little bit of rocket thrust, hit the button, then a lot of rocket thrust, and then stopping. This is the proper sequence. Just be very, very twitchy with your controls and everything should be fine. Alright, we have our Eve plane in space now, but not in orbit yet, because of course we need to go sideways more, which I suggest we do. We're still on our launch stage, which has... oh my god, this thing has a wobble. gonna limit the thrust here, thrust limiter to like 38%, then it can just give full throttle and maybe not have everyone go crazy. Or perhaps I can shut down the gimbal limit. I can... Ooh, this is nice. These controls are good. Now I can up the thrust, but this thing is now restricted to like 10% of its gimbal authority. That should be good. Chat is reporting they are experiencing connection issues. That's not good. Let's cut the engines and I'll chop and see what my streaming software is saying. It's saying 0 dropped frames. It's saying 3 megabit per second up rate. It's saying everything should be fine. I don't know what's up with that. What kind of connection issues are you experiencing? Is it just dropping out completely or stuttering, or what is going on? Ah, right, we're reconnected with a cable. That's always better than Wi-Fi. Let's see. Time warp to Apple Apps. I'm really liking the Time Warp 2 function, obviously. And let's deploy our singular solar panel. Now we do have Valentina on board, so we don't have to worry too much about running out of power. But it's just good form to, you know, extend the solar panel if you have one. Alright, let's gently turn around to prograde again. We can ask Valentina to do that. Let's see. So what is new in 1.1? Almost every system has been overhauled, and I mean the game isn't completely different, but it does feel a whole lot more polished. Which is nice, because even though it was version 1.0, it still had to feel like a project. Like you had to have been around for a while and know a lot of things. Chad is asking, will I do a career playthrough of Kerbal Space Program? I might. I do like the space game, but I might do it only on stream, because I am quite sick of rendering videos, uploading them, and, you know, managing the video files and worrying about whether an episodic format, whether there's enough content, whether I'm doing the nice things or boring things. I might try to do a little bit more evening streaming, where we just do live interaction and, well, then just archive them to the YouTubes. But first we're gonna do an XCOM playthrough on Legendary difficulty. That should be interesting as well. Because, man, XCOM is just the best, but you know that already. Eve set a target. We're going there. And we are going there without too much concern. Hey, look at that. We are already headed in the right direction. We are going to escape Kerbin and worry about our intercept from there. Like... whoa, that's already way too fast. That's also 2 kilometers per second. Alright, we're just going to get into solar space and then worry about the intercept, because we have a lot of delta V left, I think. This should be good, and we shouldn't have to worry about meaningless things like thrust to weight ratio, fuel efficiency, delta V efficiency. If we manage to smack Valentina into the Evian atmosphere, then we should be golden. That's basically all we're literally and figuratively shooting for. Let's see, stopping the engines. We are on our way out of the Kerbal solar system. The Kerbin system, of course, not the Kerbal solar system. Are you kidding me? That is not the same thing at all. A rocket scientist should know. Let's forget everything I just said and let's try and make a somewhat decent intercept regardless. Eve is over there. And then we'll do the node afterwards. This will at least get the altitude in the ballpark, 230 meters per second more. This bar is now white as well for a little bit more contrast. Good, it's all these little things that are worth it. Cool. We are definitely booking it out of here. Let's warp to that point. And Valentina can wave bye to Kerbin. She's never going to see that again. We know that. She still has hope that she's going to return someday. Time warp complete. We are now in solar space. Actually, not quite yet. There's a minute to go. Boom. Solar space. And are we now ascending or descending? We are ascending. So we're headed towards the ascending node here, which is the perfect point to fix our inclination relative to Eve. Now, we don't necessarily need to do this, but it's nice because then our orbits will be in the same plane. The maneuver node is something they apparently made worse. If I grab it and drag it, or maybe I just went crazy. To be honest, my mouse is due replacement, so it could be me. Let's not blast the game for my shitty hardware. That's a tad unfair. There we go, 0.0, and that will make setting up encounters a lot easier. We will shut down Time Warp first. We will ask Valentina to orient towards the maneuver node, and then we will actually re-Time Warp because we are not at the time for the node yet. This will happen in 10 days, which is 60 hours because these are Kerbal days. Best not to forget that. Otherwise, you will easily overshoot your designated window. The Logitech G502 mouse makes you happy but ugly. Something I learned from the chat here on Twitch. Really good. I'm currently working with a Razer Imperator, which was quite nice for however long I had it, which I think is 5 or 6 years now, but the left clicker is getting wonky. I might open it up and try and fix it, and if I then inevitably break it, get a replacement. But first I'll try my do-it-yourself electronic skills fixing clickers and stuff. I read on the internet that it's apparently super easy, so I should be able to do it. I should also be able to match inclinations with Eve. This is something that is now done, more or less. Yeah, 0.1, that's good enough. Good enough for me, Sunny. And what we can do now is reduce our speed so that our... Yeah, there's that mouse again. Reduce our speed so that our orbit is just a tiny bit inside Eve's, or ideally at the same altitude. And then whilst at that altitude, we will make an encounter. Right, maximum gimbal authority, please. Here we go. Actually, the steering thrust is doing a lot more for my course than the maneuver thrust ever would. So there's something going wrong there. I think this should be good enough. We didn't really do anything, but look at that. Our periapsis is very close to Eve's altitude. Let's see, can we make an encounter this way? Yes, but it's really expensive. Can we also make one by making the orbit larger? That should be easier. Actually, this altitude is not samey enough yet, because if it was the same, then I would be able to make an encounter happen by just elongating my own orbit, because that would change my period, but obviously it wouldn't change Venus's period, Eve's period, so I would at some point inevitably rendezvous. Let's see, Eve is now actually descending, that means heading in this direction, or am I doing a counterclockwise orbit here? That would be stupid. We could go for the incredibly expensive rendezvous. It will be the fastest. Yeah, let's go for the expensive rendezvous. We have the fuel, after all, I think. 2.5 kilometers per second with 2 tanks on just another tank. This has a rocket engine too. Yeah, we'll be fine. Come on, let's not worry about small things like efficiency. All we have to do now is warp for 208 days. We'll throw in a quick save for good measure. Because this time warp, we only have 100,000 times time warp. That will then take us quite a few real time seconds. On the other hand, we're through a quarter of it already, so it's not actually that bad. Yeah, there is a way to check the position of Eve in the next orbit, or at least the effect of your maneuver node on the next orbit. That's that button. But here, look at that. I've already made a maneuver node that will allow us to get there relatively quickly. We might even say hello to Moho on the way. And just to be sure that I don't mess everything up, I'm going to throw a quick save so that if I do mess everything up, we can just resume from here. Let's see, there is our maneuver node. The time warp was successful. We're going to have a sputtering rocket to do our turn with. Give it a little bit more gimbal authority. Head for the maneuver node. There it is. And I do wonder what the part counts are now going to be like, the performance with that. I might try and load up my Elo and Tylo orbital super base save, although that has not been updated for the pre-release version. Oh, that's asking for trouble. It was already in so much trouble at the end of that series. It kind of failed because it kept exploding on its own, which isn't a good thing for bases to do. It was very frustrating. So yeah, let's not do that. But we'll try and launch something massively huge. We'll try and launch something massively huge after this gets to Eve. Let's try physics time warp. See, this craft should be small enough to not be affected by that too negatively. Alright then, we have 4 minutes of burn to go. Divided by 4 times physics warp is a minute. That'll be good. That will be good. And our fuel is... Ooh, the fuel might actually be tight. We're about halfway through the fuel. And we're also about halfway through the Delta V. Now, for the second half, obviously, it doesn't need to carry all the rest of the fuel. Yeah, I should launch the Borg ship. Griswolf, the guy in the chat, now he made a ship, like, also more than a year ago for the series. And that had a lot of parts, and we had a lot of fun launching that. But I lost the video footage of that. That was bad. But I don't think I have these files at the ready. We'll just make a massive booster pancake or something. But first, we'll get Valentina to Eve. That's for sure. Let's have a look at the map, how this is going. Let's delete the maneuver node. Here we go. Now we can just look at the closest approach here. We're about to make it. And you know, with a encounter like this, we will at least be sure to hit the Eve atmosphere really quickly, which is a good way to test our heat shield and get into all kinds of trouble. Right, this will not take long at all. Let's see, Eve encounter, let's warp there. It's another 30 seconds of time warping, maybe. We have a bit of fuel remaining. Oh yeah, this solar panel was always intended to die. It just needed to charge up the batteries whilst in space, so that we at least hit the Eve descent with charged batteries. That's the only thing it's gonna do, nothing else. Alright then, 40 days, 30 days, and then we hit Eve. What I could also do after hitting Eve, and well, we're going to launch something massive regardless, but then is the question of what to do then. I have until about 9:15-ish, I could try and start the Legend playthrough of XCOM, but that's probably going to be too tight. So I've done a few trial runs at the first one or two missions on Legend, and I'm currently so used to rocket launchers, plasma weapons, massively powerful abilities like mimic beacons, that I tend to do really badly in the first few missions. So we could conceivably actually need to spend a few tries on getting that campaign off to a good start. so I want to take my time with that. Why is this not going closer to Eve? Oh, it is, but the display... Oh, this is Gilly, not Eve. Ah, there we go. I thought the display was bugging out really hard. Alright. Eve atmosphere. 135 kilometers? Sound like a good interface altitude? I think so. Another 600 meters per second. It's going to be interesting to see whether or not that's going to be reasonable. Actually, I don't think it is reasonable. Full thrust here. Or, yeah, we will, especially if we count this fuel and this engine, we will make it. We'll slam into that atmosphere, like, ridiculously hard. But we'll make it. We'll make it to the atmosphere, that is. Absolutely no guarantees about Valentina or the ship. No, 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 no guarantees there. But we'll make it to the atmosphere. We'll see the nice purple thing. Because we're Twitch YouTuber gamer people. They told us there was better atmosphere in this batch. Well, we went to the planet with the most atmosphere. Apart from the sun, probably. Let's not overshoot here, because we're headed straight for the planet. We're now really headed straight for the planet. Let's go anti-normal and fix that a little bit. Because this is probably a little bit too aggressive even for our plucky heat shield. Go, let's get that Baryapsis out of the planet. Or what am I doing? This is the proper button to press, right? The anti-radial button, I think it is. Seems to be turning around more than it's going outside the planet. There we go, this is definitely going outside the planet now. I don't know why it's also going around so much, but... No, I want... Maybe I need radial out rather than normal or anti-normal. Oh, I'm an idiot. I'm not a good rocket scientist after all. Surprise, I've been an imposter this entire time. Here we go. This is the key I meant. 135? That should be braking altitude here, right? Let me quickly Google that on my... Joule also has a lot of atmosphere. That it does. Eve, atmosphere... Just really quickly Googling... what that altitude is. We're not sending space probes to investigate. Atmospheric characteristics, scale height, atmospheric height 90,000 meters. We need to go lower than this. We need to go radial in and tweak that a bit. Note to self, design next ships with reverse thrusters so we don't need to turn around always. Alright, 90 kilometers, then we're gonna go for 65. Yes, sounds good. And then just before hitting the atmosphere, we are going to pump some reverse thrust into those rockets. We're gonna throw the quick save here, so that from here we can try lots and lots of times. Where is the planet? There is the planet. Quick save from here. There we go. Oh, we're still 4,000 kilometers away. This is a big one. Big planet. Alright, we are now at 290. We are probably at a good altitude to start braking. 4,400 kilometers per second. Anyone want to take bets? I'm betting on Valentina's roasted corpse, unfortunately. We're quite almost literally plummeting straight to the ground, because in the time it took to do that rotation maneuver, we plummeted 200 kilometers down. That's fast. Alright, this engine is now destroyed. Now it's destroyed, but it's also gone. And what I meant to say was it ran out of fuel. Alright, let's brake a little bit more. We are now committed to actually breaching the surface. Baryapsis is at 43 kilometers. Now I want to... save some fuel for aerial maneuvering, but I want to burn most of it, ensuring we actually survive entry into that air. Let's also re-enable the authorities on these things. Right, we have done our duty of deceleration. This bloom is maybe a tad unrealistic. We'll cut the engine, face forward, and allow our heat shield to do its thing. We're still 60 kilometers away from actually hitting the interface, but you never know. Oh, our control surfaces isn't even offset. I have to remember. Right is up, left is down, down is right. Oh, up is no, down is right, up is left, roll is still roll. Yeah. Easy. This is the easiest airplane ever. And we're going to hit atmosphere. I think the solar panel will last until 80 kilometers. Whoa! Oh, that was the solar panel. We're going to go into a gentle roll to spread out the explosions evenly along the whole radius of the plane. Oh my god, is this even still a plane? No, the whole plane burned away. Okay, that's realistic. Whoops. Let's see if the heat shield will hold then. Let's not click this button. Oh shit, hey, it looks like something is still gonna burn. Let's keep rolling it, barbecue it in and out of the flame. Actually, the astronauts on the Apollo mission, they called their, they had like, I think, a 1 per minute rotation on their capsule. They called it the barbecue roll because it would like evenly distribute the heating from the sun. Valentina is now decelerating at like 10 G's, but that's now retracting. Unfortunately, she is over the Eve Sea. Now, I designed the plane with control surfaces so that it could then steer towards land, but seeing how rapidly that plane disintegrated, I think that's never gonna happen. We are going to try a few times again, but yeah, this interface is pretty stark, by the way. There's black, 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 deep purple. Alright then, we are going to go down. Now we can jettison the burnt out heat shield. And this atmosphere is so thick that it causes funny effects like this, where even though we're both in free fall, it's going to be like really hard to get away from this parachute, or get away from this heat shield, because it is experiencing so much drag, because we're at like 50 bars already, that it's kind of glued to the capsule. I'm trying my best to get it to go away, but we are out of electric charge and our reaction wheel got blasted off in that inferno. We could enable the parachutes. It's safe to deploy them, but that would mean, I mean, we can deploy one that will get rid of the stupid heat shield, and we are now ironically falling faster than the heat shield, even though we have a parachute deployed. That doesn't feel right. That's probably not right, but we're going very slowly now, so we're now going to cut the parachute because we've got another one, and we're accelerating ever so slightly with the parachute cut. I wonder if this is actually a flat or a C, which we will discover shortly. Let's see, there's even air effects as we approach the surface. I shouldn't be blind with regard to the altimeter. It might not be accurate. We will activate our last parachute. I wonder if the Eve pressure is actually also 90 bars. I'm thinking about Venus, about the real solar system, where we fell the last like 10 kilometers at 6 meters per second. This does feel a lot thinner than that. That said, this is looking more and more like a terribly scary ocean. Let's see what Valentina will... we can view. Oh yeah, we can like go inside her. Let's see what she makes of it with a jetpack. Can she slow down enough? Oh no, the gravity is too strong and the atmosphere is too thin. However, maybe it's not. We are not accelerating anymore. If I let go of the jetpack, we're accelerating. can we make it so that we're actually decelerating? Yes, now we're decelerating. We're decelerating really, really slowly, though. Look, there's our heat shield. Valentina probably cannot make a head-on collision with this Mercury Lake or whatever it is. Whoa! Whoa! We're underwater! Holy shit, this is also new. Cool. Oh, look at that, everything is pink now. Oh, that is cool, a different render, a refraction index for the water or whatever it is. The physics are still largely the same, but... Oh, that is cool, that's much better than just a random... than just a random explosion. Alright, let's quick load and see if we can some way, somehow make it into this atmosphere. We're going to do this with a little bit more control. We're going to try and do this properly. We are going to increase our altitude a little bit. And aero brake in a few passes. I'm going the wrong way. Come on. The atmosphere is at 90. So we're going for 85. And I'm counting on the fact that at 85 we will not encounter any significant braking. We will use our rocket for most of that, just so that we are going to be in atmosphere and captured in orbit. So now we're going to aim retrograde. Whoa, 85 might be too much even. Maybe it's just for the heat shield. Oh, we're still going to be on fire with a lot of things. Let's aim the engine forwards. Let's do a little bit of engine firing. Oh my god, it really matters. The heat effects compound quickly. It really matters which parts you expose to the airstream. Look at that, now our engine is going to blow up. Which is actually fine. We're using our spent stage as one big heat shield. Are we close to being captured? Not at all. We need to fire it as well. And I hope we can keep our engine as the heat shield, but I think we won't be able to. Because look at that thing. Our orbit is still a massive escape trajectory. Now it's not. So, next pass, we'll be going marginally slower. But we won't have the big engine as a heat shield. So maybe it's better to do a lot of engine braking here. We won't be coming in from so high. And once we're at apoapsis, we will increase our periapsis to, let's say, 87, 86. I think that ought to be a good altitude for a little bit of safe aero braking. Time warp completed. I want to be at literal apoapsis. Let's go. Let's aim retrograde. No, let's aim prograde. I want to raise my altitude ever so slightly. 6. Alright, 86. We're going to aim definitely prograde because our quite hilariously undersized heat shield is going to have to take a lot of punishment from Eve here. Let's go into the right attitude. Let's streamline. We want to brake, but we don't want to burn. I think this is true for everyone and everything ever. We want a brake and we don't want to burn. We definitely don't want to burn out. But here we want to brake and we also don't want to burn. A little bit of scorching would be fine. We don't care about that. But we want to keep all of our parts intact, please. Alright, we are decelerating, if slowly. Is it even visible? It is visible, but maybe we have been a little bit too conservative. That's a thing that can happen. We are at our lowest altitude now. Ooh, the heat shield is actually starting to glow, so maybe it wasn't that bad. Let's try if we deviate from our flight path. We don't immediately incinerate, but it's definitely measurable what happens. Let's see, what happens if I like present my wings for some increased drag? That should work, right? If I tumble, I have more drag and thus slow down more. Yes, alright, this is far too conservative. Let's fire rockets again. I want the shallowest imaginable trajectory, so I'm going to keep firing rockets until this also reads like 90. Then we have 90 by 80, that should be a good re-entry corridor. 80. So I'm going to re-time warp to the other side, because I want it so shallow that there's no more than 10 kilometer difference from side to side. Oh, and there is a problem here. It's not a big problem yet. The solar panel has already burned, but I am now of course using power over a long stretch of time. That is the problem I was referring to. Another problem is that we're now heading into the airstream engine first. That is not the intent. This is going to be a challenge, because we have never been this low with this heat shield before. Let's see if this works. I thought I could time warp to the 80 kilometer mark and then turn around and rocket, but I'm now realizing that that may actually not be possible. We are measurably losing altitude on the apoapsis. We are also measurably on fire. Let's get that barbecue roll going. Slightly faster than our own Apollo astronauts did it, but you can see the heat bar appearing and then disappearing. We need to increase speed to this rotation. We are being barbecued here. We're at our periapsis now. You see, we're a space fish being rotisseried in Eve's atmosphere. Cruel mistress that it is. We are now gaining altitude again, so we'll probably make it this pass. Our altitude hasn't decreased too much yet. And now that we're rising again, I'm tempted to turn around and fire our engine. It is troubling that we're not slowing down a lot, but we are almost incinerating. They made the aerodynamics a lot more challenging, that's for sure. Alright, let's try and turn around. We'll give the SAS system a try at that. We should now be on fire if we were in thicker atmosphere, but we're not. So here we go, boost, boost, boost. Let's drop our apoapsis to like slightly out of the atmosphere. And then at apoapsis, we're just gonna have to slow down in like a full pass around the planet. Yeah, now we can warp to apoapsis, which is still outside of the atmosphere. And yes, I realize I have just wasted my entire reserve of fuel. But better a surviving... that also means we slow down faster, right? I mean, we're not as heavy. And now I'm going to go forwards again, because I want the shallowest possible approach. Now that I'm saying this, a shallow approach also means more time in the barbecue, but it means less heating overall. So we'll go with this, 70 by 100. It's this or nothing. Do or die. And all the excitement is probably going to happen on the night side. Here we are, going into the barbecue again. Oh god. I can't do it better than this, Valentina. Your heat shield is already an eighth gone. That's possibly not a problem. We are at 3 kilometers per second that we need to get rid of. And I do trust in the heat shield. That thing will be fine. But the rest of the ship, quite possibly it will not be fine. Alright, physics time warp is on. We are... The problem is for sure that we're measurably heating, but almost immeasurably slowing down. It's time to activate the rotisserie again. We're the only light source on this side of the planet. It seems like we're more on fire than last time. We're also going a lot deeper than last time. If we can keep the heat from killing us. That's the question. I mean, I'd be fine with some batteries burning off. Preferably not all. As long as the wings and maybe the engine were to stay attached, then we can at least still make that work. So we're now at our lowest point yet, of course not counting the previous go where we didn't go, where we went all the way to the surface. Okay, our batteries are now showing signs of overheating. Still only on one side though. Our descent is at least slowing. Now, I'm not perfectly on the prograde anymore, but I don't dare slow my really fast barbecue, because if I do that, I'm definitely going to lose the batteries. But I may have to, because... Whoa! Alright, the plane is still intact. I asked the SAS assistant, basically I asked Valentina, to... Yeah, the electric charge is all gone, the batteries are all gone, there's no way to replenish them, so our only way of steering this craft, which by the way should be fine, is now aerodynamic surfaces. So it is imperative that they don't burn off either. Let's see, we are going to stop the reaction wheels here, because we don't have power for them. Not SAS only, just off. Now we have 8 electric charge that we can keep. I don't know why I would keep it. Maybe if the control surfaces fail, I can do one last ditch control effort. But I have a surprise. This actually seems to be sort of working. The batteries couldn't stand up to it. Yeah, larger heat shield would definitely have been dandy. Something else is going to be on fire. Is that the decoupler? This is not a good thing to be on fire, because we kind of need it to stay attached to the rest of the ship. We're also not going to rise up anytime soon. And we're still traveling at 3 kilometers per second, so it's definitely the slow rotisserie that we're feeling right now. Oh, are we losing heat here? It seems to be going back and forth, but it's hard to see. How are we doing on the ablator? That's coming off worryingly quick now. Our control surfaces are starting to slowly be on fire, but these bars are actually filling up and draining relatively slowly. We're also decelerating very slowly. The engine is definitely showing signs of being in trouble. Can we, like, maybe pass some cool propellant through it to carry away heat? I don't think that's an option. We're at 63 kilometers, and we're now in our terminal descent. I don't believe we're ever going to go higher again. The whatever it is here is almost always on fire now. We are now starting to decelerate a lot faster. We're also getting into the thicker air faster. So this is the perennial do or die moment. And we're at 1/4 shield strength. Shields at 25% and falling rapidly. Is it weird that I'm still somewhat hopeful? The engine can explode, that's fine. That's just dead weight that's not going to be there anymore. The control surfaces cannot explode. Nor can this connector part, for obvious reasons. This one, I'm the most worried about this one. It seems that there is one orientation that allows it to cool, but I don't dare slow down the rotation for long enough, because if I do that, well, it might stop in the orientation that's causing it to heat, and that would obviously be bad. The problem is now going to be that the heat shield is going to run out of ablator. We're still at 2 kilometers per second. It's probably not slow enough to just passively cool to the surrounding air. I hope the heat shield has some heat soak as well. Oh god. We're not... Time to reactivate the control wheels. Ooh, what? This tumble has saved us. I don't know why we tumbled. Out of electric charge? Too thick air? We tumbled. We took some massive G's. But now, we have slowed down so much that everything is sort of fine. I don't know exactly what happened. I'm trying to find my heat shield. Is it gone? Is that what happened? It has 4 ablator points left. I sure as hell didn't initiate I sure as hell didn't initiate this. Goodbye rule, I didn't catch your departure from chat because I was worrying about saving Valentina, but yeah, you're welcome on these streams and the rest will be archived. The heat shield is now jettisoned and we are facing the challenge of controlling this runaway space plane. My god. Alright, we have some electric charge. It doesn't seem as though my construction is entirely stable. Running. Alright, we want to be aiming in the prograde direction. And can we also aim... I mean, it doesn't matter because the... Oh, I can actually replenish my electricity a little bit because I still have an engine to run. Reaction wheels, toggle them as per normal and fire the engine ever so slightly. Alright, let's try and get into a glide here. We're somewhat stabilized thanks to the engine. Let's give it a little bit of power. Powered flight is always a lot easier than any other kind of flight. And this is recharging the batteries. Now I want to turn around and go to this island because I don't want to have Valentina crash into the sea again. And I'm also going to have to be very sparing with the fuel. So now that we've established a glide in this direction, I'm going to shut down the engine. I should have brought a tail fin. But maybe if I use these things as a tail fin, somehow that didn't go so well. Let's give it some thrust again. Alright, a little bit of thrust. I want the smallest possible amount of thrust. If I go too fast, everything goes wrong. Maybe I should disable, just ask for stability assist. Alright, this is not a good space plane. I didn't want to admit it, but there it is. This thing sucks. Of course it does. It did pretty fine in the circumstances of being like 1 kilometer away from its launch origin. Oh god. Oh, look at that! Sort of stability. No. If I press roll and yaw, meaning roll and up, maybe something can happen. But I think the air is just getting too thick here. What does this lamp works here? We're not gonna make it. We can, I mean, Valentina can make it and do a really long swim, maybe. Maybe I should just disable SAS. It doesn't look like it's passively stable, this thing. It's not passively stable. I think I can definitely call that. We don't have any fuel. We have nothing remaining. It's passively stable when it's going in reverse at 52.1 meters per second. And any other thing is not stable. That's not the meaning of passively stable. Passively stable means it's hard to do anything with it. Anything untoward. You can shoot the front ring off. Enable crossfeed? No. We're so close to our target. Our target that we designated once we're like 1 kilometer away from it. But we're not gonna make that. Alright, it's time for the massive launch. I mean, I believe what's going to happen here. Valentina is going to fall on the ground. We can see what happens with the new water if there's going to be a plane falling into it. See, it's like a leaf. A steel, aluminum, tiny bit of Kerbal leaf in an alien, dangerous atmosphere. Oh, is this a stall warning? It could be a stall warning. Or it could be a general warning, because I cannot imagine a single thing that's not going wrong right at this point. Let's see how that impact is going to be shown to us, the viewer and player. Alright then, 700 more meters to go, rapid accelerations and decelerations, that's I suppose reasonable for a dangerous contraption like so. Are we even sometimes going up? No. Oh, now we are actually crashing, so Valentina would have been better not using a lander at all, just jumping out. Alright, good to know. Data point in the ongoing quest of science. Alright, let's make something big. And by big, I mean, let's see if there is a stock thing that's really large. And then we can add on lots of that. ZMAP satellite launch kit stock. Is that that's all the parts are in the satellite. Eve. Ours is already almost the largest thing, so we're just going to add a million boosters here, just to up the part count a little bit. See how it performs. This never did perform so well. I'm still not good at some things. Things like building a reasonable rocket. I mean, this will probably instantaneously explode. And it's not even that many parts. This is probably not a good simulation of what a parts-heavy rocket launch situation looks like. But I don't feel like doing a scientific experiment. We're just going to fire off a whole lot of boosters. Oh, and I saved it. Well, it's not like I want to use it again. Anyway, here we go. It's falling apart right now. Has been increased to like 20 kilometers, which is quite impressive actually. That used to be like 2.5. Actually, let's try that again and see if we can tab from part to part and see how far that can keep going. Here we go, this ridiculous contraption. Can we try a little bit of physics warp here? Yeah, with physics warp we're getting into some frame rate problems, but I don't think that counts as being before, where all the different parts kept being simulated properly. Which is quite nice, because now you can get weird. I mean, here it doesn't really matter, of course, but you can, like, conceivably build an autonomous lander and hop around with a spacewalking Kerbal, and then in the meantime fly and others. All while everyone's engine keeps firing. That is potentially very nice. So, that's it for now. I'm Lorenzo. I'm going to go to the cinema, watch a scary movie, and probably soon-ish, like evenings in the coming week, an XCOM 2 stream will commence in this space, so keep watch on it. Follow me on Twitter, that's at Lorenzo in Space, and you will be notified automatically also if you follow me on Twitch, obviously. So, that's that. I don't know what else to say. I'm gonna alt-tab out and click my buttons to stop talking to you. Well, I can stop talking of my own volition. But I need to click a button to stop the stream, which I'm doing right now.